Hey guys, how's it going? Hope you're doing well out there today. Every once in a while, I need to send a file or a folder to someone with some information for whatever reason. And there's a number of ways we can do that, whether it's self-hosted or through a service like WeTransfer, which honestly, I hadn't touched in a while. Honestly, I'm kind of glad for that now that I've taken a look at their site again. Go on a little bit of a tangent here, just very briefly, before we get into what we're going to cover today. This is WeTransfer, and it is just meant to send files and folders to people. And it has just turned into an ad platform that allows you to send files. And that is a weird combination to me. More than that, if you come over here to pricing, now we can see that you get share and receive up to 3 gigs per month, 10 transfers per month. Transfers expire up to 7 days for free, and that's fine. But then after that, it's like $25 a month base if you go the monthly route, or $19 a month if you go the yearly route. And that, just to share some files periodically, is a lot, especially when the whole thing is a marketing platform first and a file share platform second, based on what I'm seeing here. So much so that we're only seeing these ads, this dashboard, the way it is, because I'm connected to this via a VPN with no ad blocking turned on. I took a quick little second there. I disabled my VPN, and here we can see I'm using PIA, been using for years, love them. Probably have a link in the description for like an affiliate thing if you wanna check that out. But if I refresh this, hey, look. Now my local AdGuard home setup is blocking all of the nonsense in the background, because again, WeTransfer is a marketing platform first with file transfers as a way to get people here. So I think that's really weird. Luckily for us, somebody over here named Dean Ward has created a WeTransfer self-hosted alternative called Erugo. And that's what we're going to take a look at in today's video. Get all of the features and benefits of using something like WeTransfer, but self-hosted and not having to worry about being marketed to as a result of using the service. So with all of that little intro out of the way, let's take a quick look at my instance of Erugo that I've got set up on my server back behind me. Then we'll take a look through their GitHub repository and kind of look through some of that and see how easy it is to get Erugo installed via Docker. So this is my instance of Erugo that I've got set up again on the server there behind me. And we can see that it's a very, very basic dashboard. We've got an option to add files. We've got an option to add folders. Here we can see what's been added right below that. And then we've got some photo credit for the background that is on Unsplash. I dig it. I like that people are getting credit for their work rather than just being marketed to blatantly. At the bottom of the page, we've got a little powered by Erugo. And from there, we can jump over to that GitHub repository that we'll look at here in a little bit. Next, in the very bottom right-hand corner, we've got a little settings area, and we've got a logout button. Let's click settings here so that we can take a look at this. Here we can see my profile, where it's admin, it's active, my username, my email address, and my account created. And I can edit that profile to include my username, my name, my email address, my password, those sorts of things, just like you would hope for. So if we close that, we can come back over to the next tab. We're going to work backwards here. So this is my profile. But next, we'll take a look at users. And here we can see all of the users that are available here. And we can add users if we want to do that. Now, one thing to note about this is that currently, the only way that a user can be added to your platform is if you manually add users to your platform. And I actually kind of appreciate that with a service like this. We've taken a look at other similar, you know, note sharing, file sharing kinds of things in the past that were just kind of open to the public for creating accounts and that sort of thing. And in my opinion, there's a certain amount of liability when you've got an open service like that that anybody can upload to. I super appreciate that this is set up currently to make sure that an admin has to add a user to the platform and not just anybody can sign up. So just something to keep in mind there. And I really like that. That may change in the future because this is still in very, very early development state. Just as a quick little aside here, if we do jump over to the GitHub repository, we can see that the version 0.0.005 was released last week. So this is still very early development. Do with this information in this video what you will. Just understand that things may change from the time I've recorded this video until you see it, until things change. Like, any number of things could happen with an application this early in development. So there you go. We're going to come back to this page. But first, I want to take a look at this other last tab over here, which is the branding page. And if we click that, it's just that. And I love this. By default, it was, honestly, in my opinion, kind of some ugly colors. It didn't really fit my personal aesthetic choices. But if you want to, you can come over here and you can change your colors on the fly very, very quickly and easily. Just select the colors you want for your primary, your secondary, your accent, and your accent color light. And there you go. It's really just that easy. I want to come back over to here somewhere, kind of right in that area, and click save. And now we're back to that blue or something similar to what we had earlier. But that's basically it as far as the Erugo settings are concerned. If we click close there, we can click add file. We'll just grab, we'll grab that. That's just a thumbnail that I used for something the other day for a live stream or something, I'm sure. And here we can see that it's got the name, it's got the size. It says what kind of file it is. It's a PNG in this case. And we can delete that file if we want to, or we can come back and add it. And we can add multiple files here, right? We don't have to just add one file at a time. And we can click upload. And right there is the URL on how to access that shares. If I copy that, and then let's just open that in a new window or a new incognito window, we can see that we've got erugo.dbtech.tube/shares/oddfieldlatebird. That's the default naming convention for the URL strings based on the current configuration. If I hit enter there, right there, there are the two files that I've uploaded. We can see that a total size of about 830 kilobytes expires 6 days, 23 hours, 59 minutes. And that 7 days is kind of static at the moment. I'm hoping that will get changed later, but that's where it currently is everything gets a 7 day default before it expires and gets deleted from the server. So if we click download, it created a WinZip archive for us, and I can click save, and then I can come over to here. Oops, and I can click there. And of course it opened it over here. But right there is my downloads folder. Right there is Odd Field Late Bird. And I can say, extract to there. And right there are the files that we shared from that other browser session. It's really just that easy. Let's do one more thing here, just real quick. We'll close this. Now, one thing to note before we move on is that after you've shared something, once you've uploaded it to the server, you don't have access to delete it. There's no dashboard for individual users to see what files have been shared via their profile. And I kind of wish there was a dashboard for that so that shares could be stopped or deleted or whatever. But again, this is still early development and maybe the developer plans to add that later. I don't know. I haven't actually talked to them. The other thing I want to look at real quick is I want to click add folders. Right. And just for the sake of this, I'm going to change the name of this to pictures. And then I'm going to click upload. And it says, hey, this will upload all files from pictures. Only do this if you trust the site. I'm going to click upload. And hey, look, there we are. I can click upload. And right there, Rapid Cloud Jolly Tooth then becomes our share URL. And again, I can copy that new window. And there it is. There are those files again. Just that simple and easy to use this platform. It's very basic. It's to the point. I've said this before, and I will continue to say this. I always love an app. Even if it only does one thing, if it does that one thing really, really well, I'm super, super happy with that. And I feel like Erugo is that app for file sharing. If you just need to share a couple of things, or a bunch of things, you can absolutely do that with no issue using Erugo. And since we've taken a look at how easy it is to use, let's take a look at how easy it is to get installed. So here we are, we're back on the Erugo GitHub repository, again from Dean Ward. And here we can see all of the code that's in here. I love that all of this is currently available. You can just look through here and see what's going on. And it's all written in Go and Vue.js for the front end. Everything is in here. You can just dig through it and do what you want to do with that information. We can scroll down and we can see Erugo is a secure self-hosted alternative to WeTransfer built in Go and Vue.js. It combines powerful file sharing sharing capabilities with a sleek user interface, all packaged in a single, easy-to-build binary. Now, of course, here on DB Tech, we do almost everything in Docker, because that's just what we do here. So that's how we're going to install this. Just know that you can do it a number of different ways based on what you find here on the GitHub repository. So we're just going to scroll down. Here we can see some more screenshots of how all of this looks. Key features, effortless deployment. We're going to see that. Human-friendly share links, easy-to-read URLs, like what we saw earlier, patient A's tiny term in this case. Secure access control. Only authorized users can create shares, while anyone with a link can download. Simple data management uses a SQLite database for efficient metadata storage, flexible configuration, customizable storage paths, and share size limits, interactive setup, user-friendly first run configuration using Bubble Tea, modern interface, open source MIT licensing. So we've got some stuff for quick start here for Mac and Linux users. Again, if you want to use the binary, you can do that. But again, we're going to scroll down to this section right here where we can see the Docker Compose that I used to deploy this. I'm going to zoom in on this just a little bit so it's a little easier to read. And we can see that our services, there's just one service here. It is Erugo. The image is over on the hub.docker.com repository under warty7484/Erugo, in this case, latest tag there. By default, it runs on port 9199. It's built some volumes here for us, some Docker volumes. You could, if you wanted to, actually use a mapped path for that instead. I'll show that in a minute, but using volumes with this is probably more secure, depending on how you want to approach your instance. Next, we've got some environment variables for the base storage, the app URL. Again, if you're going to host this locally, you can just use, you know, like 192.168.0.215 or whatever, right? Whatever your local URL access is going to be, IP address, whatever. I've put this on a reverse proxy using Cloudflare tunnels, keeping in mind that doing that does limit us to 100 megs of upload because of Cloudflare tunnels. So that is kind of the one downside to using a tunnel service like that. But you could also use a reverse proxy like Nginx Proxy Manager or Caddy or Traffic or Pangolin. Lots of options out there. I'm just currently using Cloudflare tunnels to test this, and I did notice an instance where I couldn't upload anything above 100 megs. So just something to keep in mind. We've got a bind port, which is declared down here, which is the same as up there. We've got a database file path. We've got a max share size by default of 2 gigs. You can drop that down considerably if you want to do that, or make it bigger depending on what your needs are. Again, you've got a JWT secret for encryption. This is a secure secret in production. Change this to a long string of random characters. We've also got a private data path and a restart policy of unless stopped. And then below that, we've got a couple of volumes, one for storage and one for the private files, including the database and a logo.png file if you want to upload one of those. So you can manipulate this as you need to for your specific use case. But this is more or less what I went with my setup. There are some additional, in fact, you can see everything down here, the app URL, storage path, all of those are all of these environment variables that are listed down here are what we see up here. Their environment variable, the option, the description, and the default value, just in case you need a refresher or more information about what each of those things is. And then using Erugo, creating a share, logging in, very, very straightforward at that point. What I want to do here, though, is jump over to Portainer, where I've got this installed. What I'm going to do is I'm going to redeploy this like so. But I'm going to put a 2 on the end of all of these, so that we can go through that setup process again. Now we'll see that just a moment ago, I had like /docker/erugo/erugo-storage as the mapped path. The reason I had that is because I wanted to see what would happen back here. And here we can see that I'm in, you know, /docker/erugo right here. And if I do an ls, I can see that I've got Erugo storage as that folder. So if I do a cd into Erugo storage and then an ls, right there are all of the different folders that were created with the files in them, or the zip folders that were generated for the download. So all of that happens in there in this mapped path. However, again, for the sake of security, to keep bad actors out of your applications, I think using a Docker volume in this particular instance is probably a more secure option. So the only other thing I changed was the Erugo app URL. I put it on, again, that domain that we just took a look at a moment ago on a Cloudflare tunnel. So I'm going to change this. I'm going to change this to 1 gig instead of 2 gigs, just so we can see the actual change. So now that I'm happy with all of this, I'm going to click the blue button. If this is your first time deploying it, it will say deploy the container or deploy the stack. I don't remember which, but now I'm just going to click update, and we'll click update, and we're going to give this a second to redeploy. And there we go. Just that quickly and easily. I'm going to pop that open like so. It's like, hey, let's create a new admin account for you. And now that I've got all this information entered, I can click create. It says you'll soon be redirected to the login page. This is some of that aesthetic that I'm not super, super okay with. It's fine, I guess. So I'll go ahead and get logged in. And there we go. So again, what I want to do is I want to come over to here. This orangish yellow thing is, makes me uncomfortable. I don't know. It's weird. So I'm going to come back over. I'm going to set this to this kind of like, I guess, turquoise-ish color. And it makes me feel a little bit better. But again, just that quick and easy. We click add files, max res default. There it is. Upload one file. We can copy this and we'll open a whole new browser. We'll do like Firefox. I know that's super exciting. I don't know why I got so excited about that for a second. And then I'm going to bring this over to here. Pop this open. Oops, tab. And just like that, now we can download our folder via Erugo. Okay, guys, there you go. There's Erugo. There's a new way, a simple, easy, fast, effective way to share files with no advertising being shoved in your face while you're sharing or receiving files. I love it. I think that the developer here has done a really, really good job. I would encourage you to head over to their GitHub repository and give it a star. We're up to 71. Let's see how far we can make that number go up. Again, I found this application via the self-host newsletter. It was actually came out a couple of weeks ago, and this just kind of popped back up on my radar earlier today, and I dig it. I think you will too. Would love to know your thoughts about it in the comments section down below. But I think with all that said, I'm going to wrap this up. I want to thank you guys for spending a few minutes of your day with me here today, and I'll talk to you in the next video.